Marketing your small business can be really confusing these days. Everywhere you turn, someone else is telling you, you need to create videos. How about your SEO? Let's create some Facebook ads or podcasts or content is king. It's daunting. So in this video, I'm gonna tell you the 6 marketing strategies that actually work in 2021. And make sure to stay tuned until the end because I'm gonna tell you the 3 strategies that you probably should avoid. Hey everybody, welcome back. And if you are new to my channel, we talk everything marketing and business to help you grow. If I could get all the money back that I've wasted over the years on marketing strategies or the hottest new trends, I could take me and my wife on a very nice vacation. And I may be talking here like I'm an expert, but I have nothing to sell to you. And by that, I mean I'm not making any money from you taking my advice. I'm just sharing with you what I've learned over the last 20 years and telling it like it is. So the strategies I am sharing with you today are the ideas that I would implement if I became a partner in your business. And the first marketing strategy that I would implement in 2021 is getting started with voice search. Hey Google, I need a plumber in West Palm Beach. How would you like to be one of the top 3 results right here? As a business owner, you need to pay very close attention to this. As of right now, almost 40% of all millennials use voice search on a daily basis, and over 10% of the boomers are doing the same. In the US alone, 13% of households own a search speaker. That's over 21 million of those bad boys across the US. And that's not going away. Everything points to an explosion of search devices in the near future. The days of who is the best dentist near me? How much does it cost to replace a roof? Or I need a divorce lawyer now or already here. So you need a strategic plan for that. And the time to get started for it is now, because Wi-Fi enabled devices will be everywhere. They're already in cars, on stovetops, on refrigerators, and sometime even in your bathroom. And what's predictable is that people will search for your product and services that same way. And if getting optimized for voice search isn't obvious to you, please put it in the comments and I'll create a tutorial just for that. The good news is if you get started now, you'll be way ahead of your competition. And you'll be able to pick up the low-hanging fruits simply because so few businesses have this on their radar. The second strategy that is working very well in 2021 is to focus on the customer experience. Now you might be thinking, wait a minute, that's not a marketing strategy, but stay with me here. It actually is. Marketing is the art of promoting your products and services of your business. And when the customer experience is awesome, people will talk about it. That means that they are telling their friends how amazing you are. And that, my friend, is priceless marketing for you, because nothing beats a strong referral. And in many cases, it's probably the cheapest way to market your business. For instance, what is one of the top complaints that people have with vendors or contractors that are coming to your home? They're never on time. And on top of that, if you're like most people, you have to be there between the window of 12 p.m. to 6 p.m. on Thursday to be there for them. Like I have to waste my day for their convenience. But check out what this landscaping business in Sydney, Australia is doing. They do 2 things with the customer experience that are awesome. First, they'll tell you they'll be there at 3:10 sharp on Thursday. Not 3 p.m., not a specific window of time, but 3:10 on Thursday. And the odd time is done on purpose. It's called the unusual factor, and it gets people's attention. They want to know if you mean it. Second, they'll tell you they'll be there on time or the service is free. Talk about a guarantee, right? Their customers stand on the driveway checking their watch to see if they're going to be on time. And to their amazement, the truck pulls up exactly and precisely at 3:10. So what's the trick? It's very simple, in fact. The company only takes 2 appointments per day, 1 in the morning and 1 in the afternoon. The drivers are instructed to arrive in the neighborhood at least 15 to 20 minutes ahead of time and park themselves just around the corner. And at 3:08, they start driving towards the house and, of course, arrive every single time precisely at 3:10. Every single time. So what happens? Customers take pictures, they take short videos, they post it on social media and tell all their friends about it. But here's what's amazing about this strategy. This landscape company does not spend a dime on marketing. Zero, nada, zilch. That is their strategy. Their marketing strategy is by providing an amazing customer experience by being on time. Guaranteed. And as a result, they are booked solid 6 months out. So what are the top complaints in your industry? What could you do to shift the customer experience and having people starting to talk about you? That's a low-cost marketing strategy worth discovering. The third strategy that is working in 2021 is having your Google My Business complete. If you're doing business in a local geographic area, this is the best place to start. Because as a local business owner, you have to win in your own backyard. Making sure that your Google My Business is accurate and up to date is the fastest way to make the phone ring. And best of all, it's free. Now, the reason why this is one of my go-to strategies is because of intent, as in the intent to buy. When people are searching for plumber near me or teeth whitening near me, you can bet that their intent of getting that service is super strong, as opposed to people who are on Facebook or Instagram, which are just browsing. They don't have an intent to buy. They're just checking out what their friends are up to and posting their latest photos. They're just dreaming and passing time. Someone on Google My Business isn't dreaming. They have intent. They're not just passing time. They're ready now and they're looking for who is going to get their money. Now, when someone searches on Google your products or services near me, Google will show them what is called the local three pack. And the three pack will get 90% of all the clicks. So if you need help making sure that your Google My Business is up to date, check out this recent video. There's a link in the description. The number four strategy is long form blog content. You've probably heard it 1,000 times. Content is king. And it is. But too much of the wrong kind of content can be a royal nightmare. Too many marketing professionals have been selling content packages to small business owners that simply do not work. They'll post blogs on your website once or twice a week just to keep it fresh. But here's the bad news. In 99% of the cases, it's a complete waste of time. It's true that Google likes fresh new content, but I can guarantee you that those 500 words blogs that your agency is posting is not what the Google algorithm likes. And in many cases, it can be detrimental because Google will tag your website as a source of useless content and won't promote it at all. What I've done for many years now is invest time and money in long-form blog content. And it still works because content that is well-crafted and very useful will still generate a ton of traffic for your website. And what's more important is I don't focus on quantity at all. I focus on quality. And I may only invest in creating one blog in a quarter. But that blog post is going to be awesome. I use this technique for a dental office in South Florida. Instead of producing a bunch of crappy, useless content, we focused on 5 blog posts in the entire year. I'm not kidding, just 5 blog posts for the year. And one of those 5 we created was the Dentist Ultimate Do-It-Yourself Mouthwash Recipes with 15 unique recipes. And that was in 2016. And to this day, this is still their number one source of organic traffic to their website with hundreds of hits every single week. Now, many of those hits are from people that are outside the local area. But the fact that this post is so strong and posted on this local dentist website makes the authority of his website the strongest in the area. And that by a long shot. The end result was a 35% growth in new customers for 3 years in a row. So what is true is that a blog like this is going to require a lot of research and a lot of work. And it's worth hiring a professional content writer and investing in some custom graphics to get it done. The fifth strategy that works in 2021 is video marketing. These days, videos are a must. And the good news is that they're extremely popular and get a lot of attention. But the bad news is they are difficult to execute and they can also be expensive and very time consuming. If you are in a very competitive field, you're going to have to execute stuff that your competition is unwilling to do or that they do very poorly. And I'm not talking about vlogging or sharing a day in your life like a Kardashian. I'm talking about creating short videos that are useful and help people interested in what you do solve their problems. To get started, make a list of the most recurring questions that people ask you all the time. Those are probably going to be your first 3 to 4 videos. Next, use Answer the Public to find out all the questions people have about what you do. There is amazing video content and the answers to every single question. In many cases, with just one keyword, you'll end up with more video ideas that can get done in the next 2 to 3 years. Give yourself a goal to create at least 10 videos in the next 12 months. Post your videos on your website, on YouTube, and on your Facebook page and see what happens. With 80% of people preferring videos over any other form of content delivery, it makes it really hard to ignore as a business owner. So here's a tip for you. Don't let your competition get ahead of you. Be the leader in your market and let them catch up to you. And the sixth strategy that works in 2021 is to tap into micro influencers. I get about 2 to 3 requests a week from brands that want to leverage my audience on YouTube. And while 99% of the time the answer is no, because it's not a good fit for my audience or I'm not willing to do what they want me to do, it's very telling what big brands have figured out already. Small influencers or even micro influencers can be amazing marketing resource. The main reason is because a micro influencer might be willing to spread the word about your company for $150, $250 or maybe $500. Most large brands with big budgets will want a large influencer with hundreds of thousands, if not millions of subscribers. But the local soccer mom in your town with 2,000 followers on Instagram might be delighted to do a showcase on your business for $200. So do a quick search on Facebook, on YouTube, and on Instagram, and try to find micro influencers in your local area. There are probably a few of them that would be delighted to earn a few $100 to make a showcase about your company, especially if your customer experience is awesome. So now you have some great strategies to apply to your business. Let's talk about the 3 things you should avoid. The first one is don't waste money with Google Ads. Now I know some of you are already screaming at me, but bear with me. I'm not saying that Google Ads are bad or that they don't work. Of course they can be good, and of course they work in many cases. But be honest with me and put it in the comments below if you've invested money in Google Ads and have very little to show for it. The issue is that in many cases it's overpriced or it's completely saturated, like lawyers or dentists or insurance agent. Another problem is that there are way too many agencies that would be willing to take your money even if they know that it's going to be a long shot for them to produce some good quality leads for your company, or that your budget is too small for you to compete. So if you're interested in Google Ads, make sure that whoever you're going to work with has a track record in your industry and in your niche. If you are a plumber, only hire an SEO expert that has a track record with plumbers and has been doing this for at least 2 to 3 years and has the results for it. Before you get started, be 100% clear on your cost of acquisition and be ready to pull the plugs if the numbers don't add up. Now, if you need info on figuring out your cost of acquisition, I've created this video and I'm going to put a link in the description. Just check it out. The number 2 things to avoid is wasting your money with SEO. I have seen too many small businesses spending between $250 to $750 a month on SEO services, and I have no idea what the SEO company is doing for that money. Fine-tuning the SEO on your website should be a yearly thing for most small businesses, and it should cost you about $500 to $1,000 one time. There's no such thing as monitoring the performance of your website on a weekly or monthly or quarterly basis. And most reports given to business owners about their SEO go unread and are mostly useless. The only info that should matter to you is customer acquisition. How many new customers did you get this month or this quarter? quarter. And the third thing you should avoid is wasting time on social media. I'm not saying that social media is a waste of time, but it's easy to waste time on social media. Having an account with every single social media platform is another waste of time. Mostly these accounts are filled with boring content that nobody reads, like, or share. And with changes with platform's algorithm, the chances are that even the people that like your page are not even seeing those posts. So here's the good news. You do not need to be active on every single social media platform. Just one is sufficient, and post there. If it's Facebook, then so be it. Who cares about Instagram, Pinterest, and Twitter? Focus your time and energy on the social media platform that is most likely going to increase your visibility with your ideal target market. So make the accounts that are not producing for you dormant and focus your time and energy on the ones that are. So that does it for today. If you got value, I would appreciate a thumbs up. Please make sure to subscribe and click the bell so you don't miss a thing. You could watch this video next or this one. And until next time, au revoir.